I've had a huge breakthrough this week. As a narrative filmmaker trying to use AI tools, one of the big issues that I have with cinematic stills and video, I can't control the eye movement. They're always looking at the camera. It's called breaking the fourth wall in narrative filmmaking terms. The idea is you've got three walls, that is the set that you're filming against, or the theatre stage that the story is being told against. And the fourth wall doesn't exist, because that's where the audience is in a theatre, or that's where the cameras are on a film set. Film sets work in a very similar way in that there's a line drawn and the cameras all stay on that side of the action in order to not disorientate the viewer. The action all takes place on one side of what's called a 180 degree line. Different video. Anyway, short version, drives me up the wall that I can't get my characters to stop looking straight down the barrel of the lens. This week I found a little clue and it led me to a breakthrough. It's not perfect, it doesn't work all the time with every tool. Different tools respond differently, but it's incredibly consistent. It works far more often than it doesn't work. So it's worth sharing because I finally figured it out. Let me tell you the story. So, I am genuinely really excited about this. So it started off when I was looking at a tool called RenderNet. It's a tool for creating consistent characters. You can create one for free. Great, let's give it a go. So I clicked, let's have a look. What does it look like? Great characters, looking very authentic. And then my eyes fell down here on this one, which said movie character. And I was like, well, that's interesting, because this movie character has two things going on that caught my attention. Number one, he's looking away from the camera. You notice everybody else is looking straight at the camera and this guy isn't. I'm like, what have they done? What do they know? What have they finally clued in on that lets everybody know it's a movie character? The other hint is that he was lit cinematically. I need to come on to what makes cinematic lighting cinematic, because that term gets thrown around all the time. And we'll come back to this. But first, the eye control. So I thought, well, let's give it a try. Try it now. And it looks good. Here's a prompt at the top here. And this is the bit that really caught my attention. Looking away from the viewer. Now, in the past, I had tried in Midjourney, don't look at the camera, don't look at the lens, look away from the lens, look away from the camera. I didn't know what to say, what terminology to use to get them to stop looking at the lens. Looking away from the viewer. Okay, so I hopped over to Midjourney. Let's give this a try. I got to cut to the chase. Midjourney was the toughest tool to get this to work consistently. Other tools worked really consistently. But Midjourney, let me show you what I tried. Start with as little information as possible. I've actually done quite a lot of research into this, and I've played around with this a lot. I find that with Midjourney, the more information in the prompt, the less it's hit and miss as to which bits it will pick and choose from. So if you're trying to really nail it down at the start, then having a prompt that has as little information in as possible gets the best results. So I started with, here we go, a cinematic photo of a beautiful girl. And what we got back was, well, one wasn't looking at the camera, three were. So that's without any eye direction at all. Okay, let's see what it looks like if we go, a cinematic photo of a beautiful girl, don't look at the camera. Okay, now all four of them are looking at the camera. Then I tried a cinematic photo of a beautiful girl not looking at the camera, and we ended up with a cinematic photo of four girls looking at the camera. And, you know, and so on and so on. A cinematic photo of a beautiful girl, don't look at the lens. Tried that. I'm just making my point here. Cinematic photo of a beautiful girl not looking at the lens. They all looked at the lens. This was interesting. I thought I might have got somewhere here. A cinematic photo of a beautiful girl looking away from the camera. Okay, not getting anywhere there. But this one, what was this one? This one was a cinematic photo of a beautiful girl looking away from the lens. that might work. There are two or three different prompts that might work and may not. So bank that one, looking away from the lens. I thought, well, that's got great results. All four of them were looking away from the lens. I tried another one, a cinematic photo of a beautiful girl looking away from the viewer. That's the one that I saw over in RenderNet. Well, this one didn't get the same kind of results. She's looking away, she's looking away. She is sort of looking away. Her eyes aren't quite on the camera. That's good. She is looking at the camera. Then I thought maybe the key is the words looking away. So I thought, does it matter what they're looking away from? So I tried. So the next prompt I tried is a cinematic photo of a beautiful girl looking away from the potato. Here's what I got. Delightful. We've got actually great results. Looking away. Looking away, looking away, looking at the camera, and every shot involving a potato. So I thought, well, let's try just the idea of just a cinematic photo of a beautiful girl looking away. And this is what we ended up with. These four here. So she's looking at the camera, she's looking away, she's looking away. Maybe you don't have to say looking away from the viewer. Maybe it's just looking away. If you're struggling, try all of those. There's a lot of experimentation to do here. So Midjourney mixed results. Now I'll cut to the chase and tell you if you get, the more information you start to add in, the more it gets tricky. So let's put the one in that worked really, really well. Let's see, a cinematic photo of a beautiful girl looking away from the lens. Let's make her a little more like one of the characters in my test scene. A cinematic photo of a beautiful girl with long brunette hair looking away from the lens in a modern skyscraper bar, London, night, warm color tones, muted orange and teal. And we get back. She's not looking at the lens. She's not looking at the lens. She is looking at the lens. She is looking at the lens. Okay, 50-50. That's good. So just to see what happens when we add a bit more information in and give her something to look at instead of just telling her don't look away or look away from the viewer. A cinematic photo of a beautiful girl with long brunette hair wearing a black cocktail dress, arguing with her boyfriend in a modern skyscraper bar, London night, warm colour tones. You'd expect her, if she's arguing with her boyfriend, to not be looking at you while she's arguing with him over here. So let's see. And we end up with... Well, she's not looking at the lens. She's not looking at her boyfriend either. Maybe that's the point. She is looking at her boyfriend, not looking at the lens. She is looking at her boyfriend, not looking at the lens. She's looking at her boyfriend, not looking at the lens. So if you give somebody something proactive to look at, that can help as well. So looking away from the viewer, looking away from the potato, looking away from the lens, they seem to work well. Let's look at Leonardo. Great results, really consistent with Leonardo, typing in looking away from the viewer. A cinematic photo of a beautiful girl looking away from the viewer, long brunette hair, wearing a black cocktail dress in the modern skyscraper wine bar, eye direction looking away from the viewer. I kind of doubled down to see if that would help. A cinematic photo of a beautiful girl looking away from the viewer. That worked really, really well. And the next one worked really, really well. The next one really, really well. The next one really, really well. This is an even... That was even without me trying to have a look away from the viewer. Leonardo seems to instinctively get it. LTX Studio. Let's type in a prompt that involves a cinematic photo of a beautiful girl looking away from the viewer. And what do we have? She's looking at the camera. Let's see what happens if we type just looking away. Any progress there? Let's try re-rolling. Okay, finally we've got somebody looking away from the camera. LTX Studio needs to absolutely nail this. Above all, they are pitching themselves as a filmmaking tool. They have got to get this sorted so that the default setting is looking away from the camera. It mustn't be this difficult. Runway. I tried this shot, a cinematic photo of a beautiful girl looking away from the viewer, long brunette hair, seemed to work quite well. Kaiber, a cinematic photo of a beautiful girl looking away from the viewer, long brunette hair, blah, blah, blah. I added looking away from the viewer twice just to reinforce it. Got this lovely shot, looking away from the viewer. Pika Labs, this worked well, a cinematic photo of a beautiful girl looking away from the viewer, long brunette hair, wearing a black cocktail dress, walking through a modern skyscraper, wine bar, looking away from the viewer. It's basically the same prompt every time. So Pika Labs, I got this shot. Again, not looking at the camera. That worked. Lens Go, I had trouble with for different reasons. Haiper, I tried it 3 times, got great results. This girl looking away from the viewer. That worked well. Then a longer shot, again, looking away from the viewer. And great, she's looking away from the viewer. I mean, this is really all I'm looking for. And again, looking away from the viewer. It's been working. PixVerse started looking away from the viewer. And then she she kind of decided to, hello, and look straight down the camera. Well, good start. Didn't get all the way there. All in all, looking good. So you remember this guy on RenderNet, and I said there were 2 things that caught my attention. One being the fact that he was looking away from the camera, you know, so he wasn't breaking the fourth wall. And the other one being the lighting, and I said it was cinematic lighting. So what is cinematic lighting? The next video is all about what it really is. You need to understand this because it's not enough to just type into a prompt cinematic lighting. You will get something back, but it's not a single kind of on-off switch. Oh, is it cinematic or is it not? It's really important to understand what it is so that when the AI tool gives you back something that you have said cinematic lighting, you know whether it is the lighting you're looking for or not.